Wednesday, April 17th, 2024. You are listening to the Daly Dose Sports Podcast, and I am your host, Clint Daly, coming to you from the Mile High City here in Denver, Colorado, and we are back for another week of talking sports with a dose of common sense. Hey, happy Wednesday to you. Hope your week is off to a strong start. You are now already halfway to another weekend, and you know what? This time of the year, it's even more fun. Because we're starting to get into that warm time of year. You can actually go outside. You can do some good things. You can actually get out from your house and actually go out in the sun and maybe enjoy the weather a little bit in that spring season. And that is always a good thing. So I hope that your week is going well. I hope that you, your family, your friends, everyone in your world is staying strong and you're staying healthy right now. And yes, kids, let's get it out of the way. Let's just talk about it. We haven't discussed it. Let's just put it right there. We have to talk about it. We just missed it last week, but here on The Dose, we have to discuss one giant elephant in the room. Of course, it was massive news last Thursday when former NFL running back OJ Simpson died of cancer at the age of 76. You know, I'll be very, very honest with you, and I'll self-admit I'm old, but I barely remember OJ's playing career at all. Like, I know what he did. I understand what he did. I realize he went to 5 straight Pro Bowls. He was a first-team All-Pro selection from 72 to 76. He led the league in rushing yards 4 different times, in rushing touchdowns twice, in points scored in 75. He became the first NFL player to rush for more than 2,000 yards in a season, which earned him the NFL's Most Valuable Player of the Year award. And OJ Simpson is the only NFL player to do it in a 14-game regular season. That's pretty impressive. He holds the record for the single season yards per game average. He averaged 143 yards per game. Having said that, I'll be very transparent. I'll be very honest with you. That stuff was before my time. I don't remember it. I really don't. The only true memory that I really have of OJ Simpson as a player is when I was like a really, really little kid. And the Buffalo Bills were coming to Denver to take on, you know, my Denver Broncos. And I was excited for the game. It was very early in the season, maybe the second game of the year, something like that. And I was talking about it, you know, in my neighborhood. And I remember my next door neighbor, who was a little bit older than me, he was telling me how OJ is going to light up my beloved, you know, Donkeys, as he called them. I was like, no way. The Orange Crush is legit. That's a good defense. He was like, you just wait. OJ's going to light you up. You'll see. But, like I said, this was when I was little, and his prime days were before that. So OJ was just maybe a touch past his prime at this time. And the Orange Crush actually was legitimate defense. The Broncos held him to 43 yards rushing. They blew Buffalo out by 20. And I got to go chirp to my next door neighbor and tell him, yeah, where was OJ? What was that all about? You told me what he was going to do. He didn't do nothing. Yeah, I remember that. That's about as much as I remember. OJ Simpson's prime is before my time. I do remember him working on NBC as a commentator down on the field. I remember him in the Naked Gun movies. You know, it's bizarre to think about, just kind of a side note, when Ahmad Rashad, remember the great wide receiver Ahmad Rashad? When he married Felicia Allen, who was the mom on The Cosby Show, Ahmad Rashad's groomsmen were OJ Simpson and Bill Cosby. Wow. That is insane. I defy you to find me a more wild wedding party than that must have been. I'll just warn everyone involved, don't drink too much at that reception. Whew. That could go sideways real fast. Now, to refresh some of OJ's more recent accomplishments, of course, he was arrested in 1994. He was tried for the murder of his ex-wife and a friend of hers. And I know that we didn't have the internet then. We didn't just jump on the Twitter and read the stories. We were all glued to our TV sets. And when it was announced that OJ was the prime suspect in a double homicide and had failed to turn himself in, he would later become the subject of a low-speed pursuit by police while riding as a passenger in a white 1993 Ford Bronco, a vehicle that was owned and being driven by his former teammate and longtime friend Al Cowlings. Now, according to Cowlings, Simpson was armed in the back of the vehicle. He had a pistol that he was holding to his head. He was threatening to shoot himself if he was not taken back to his home in Brentwood. So this caused the California Highway Patrol officers to pursue with extreme caution. The police were closing the nearby highways. And the crazy part about this was that this slow speed chase all took place during the NBA Finals. Well, the NBA Finals that year, if I remember right, was Houston versus the New York Knicks. It was kind of boring. So they actually switched from the game telecast and we were watching this weird live episode of Cops, right? And we all watched to see, are we going to see something wild on TV? Like, is this going to go sideways on us? But in the end, it was much ado about nothing. Of course, OJ would eventually go to trial. He would be found not guilty. And he would tell us that he would not rest until he found the real killer. And you know what's crazy? They estimate that around 100 million people nationally tuned in to either watch or listen to the verdict announcement. Hey, that's almost a Super Bowl in terms of ratings. That's pretty amazing. Like I said, at that time, we didn't have the internet. We were all tuned in. We all found out about these things. We all knew what was going on. But it was kind of crazy because we were just watching it on TV or listening on the radio. Okay, so with OJ Simpson passing, we've heard it all in the last week. We have people who swear their support to OJ. They compare him to like civil rights leaders. We also have people that hate OJ and say that he manipulated the system with all of his money and his fame. And you know, I'll be very honest. I have a huge problem with one very specific aspect of OJ Simpson that I kind of think is getting overlooked. Because remember that OJ Simpson's lawyer in this double homicide trial was a guy by the name of Robert Kardashian. Yes, that Kardashian, the patriarch of that succubus family. It all started right there. Thanks for that, OJ. Appreciate that. So, with the passing of OJ Simpson, where do you come in? Do you cheer for Simpson? Did you cheer for Simpson? Do you believe he was a double murderer? It seems, just like in many other issues in America today, our country is very divided on this. There are people that are all for OJ. Hey, maybe he did it, but it was dirty cops and it was racism and he got away with it and good for him. And then you have the, well, it seems like he did it. He probably should have paid for it. Our country, once again, is very divided. But I'm going to say this. I know that O.J. Simpson has been involved in a lot of negativity. He had a lot of haters. I know you can find the clips on YouTube. People would scream murderer at him wherever he went. Out on the golf course, looking for the real killer, whatever. People would be yelling murderer at O.J. But also remember that here at the Daily Dose, we do prefer to keep things positive. We don't like to dwell on negative things in life. Life is too short. So I personally, today on The Dose, I am going to make this statement. I want to give OJ Simpson props. I really do. Because last Thursday, OJ Simpson finally brought the real killer in that decades-old double homicide to justice. And for that, I say, well done, Orenthal James. Hey, before we jump in today, just want to remind you, make sure you are stopping by DailyDoseSports.com, where we have new articles going up every week. We have links to the podcast. We have links to the videos. And yes, we have links to Daily Dose gear. You might need a new t-shirt. You might need a new sweatshirt. You might need a new hoodie. We've got a few styles to choose from over there. But you get to pick whatever color that you want. So make sure you're stopping by DailyDoseSports.com each week and finding exactly what you need. Hey, YouTube. Today on the show, we're actually discussing a number of things in the world of sports. We are talking a little bit of sports news. And we are doing some Daily Dose Power Rankings. With the NBA playoffs now underway, the Stanley Cup playoffs just about to get started, and Major League Baseball getting started, we actually have some Daily Dose Power Rankings to let you know which teams truly are the true contenders. Plus, we have an NBA playoff-flavored Daily Dose Top 5. You have to make sure that you stop by and check that out. I will leave a link to the full podcast here in the comments on YouTube. Hope you all are doing well. I will see you all next Wednesday. Have a great week.